Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Miss, and today I'm actually going to be introducing a new series to my channel, which is like the What If X card was actually unbanned, and the first victim will be Deng Long first of the Yang Xing. So notice the little stupid pun that obviously isn't intended. Before I start, friendly reminder to like and subscribe because it motivates me a lot to keep making videos like these. And yeah, so first of all, let's talk about Deng Long and why it got banned. So it's a level 5 synchro that reads, if this card is special summoned, you can add any Yang Xing card from your deck to your hand. So obviously we're off to a great start. You can search 9 pillars with this. Okay. And you can, once per turn, if this card is on the field, you can send for cost one Wyrm type monster from your deck to your graveyard, and then Deng Long becomes the level of that Wyrm that you actually send. So you can send Shu King monsters and Deng Long will become level 9, which obviously facilitates rank 9 VFD plays. And also, if Deng Long is actually sent from the field to the graveyard, just not even by a card effect, just sent from the field to the graveyard, you can special summon a Yang Xing monster from your deck. That isn't very fair. You can get Kaiju'd, you can synchro summon with Deng Long, you can link summon with it and still summon Yang Xing monsters. What? Other Yang Xing monsters can't do that at all. They always have the when you can clause, so they miss timing, and you know, they have to be destroyed as well. Deng Long never misses timing because it's an if effect, and also it doesn't necessarily have to be destroyed. The only kind of drawback that it has is that you can only special summon Deng Long once per turn, but who cares? So in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys, I guess, two combos. The first one is very standard. It's just if you can summon Deng Long, what you can do just with Deng Long. And I'm going to spoil it out right now. Actually, it's going to be on... you're going to end on 2 interruptions, and you don't need Needle Fiber for you to actually be able to do that. And the second combo is kind of like a hand... you know, it's not a really a deck out FTK, but it is a strategy that can make your opponent lose by decking out, since they might just not have an answer to this. This is kind of comparable to how Mystic Mind plus Field Barrier can FTK some people without, you know, necessarily FTKing your opponent, because they can still kind of just not die on the first turn, but they will never be able to win depending on how their deck is built. And the combo that I'm about to showcase you actually is literally just on the same level, you know, on the same category. So let's get into it. All right, so for combo number one, of course, it's the Overraptor combo, so you probably already could tell. If you just have Overraptor, you can do pretty much all of this. And as you can see here, I'm not actually searching the miscellaneous Zoris to my hand, and the reason why I'm doing that, I'm just sending it directly, is because I kind of want to play through Droll, because the search that I get with Deng Long is very important. But there's just literally, you know, searching miscellaneous to your hand, it doesn't really get you anything bonus. You know, it doesn't matter if Overraptor isn't going to be Nibiruable any or anything, because you're just gonna make Deng Long in literally 2 seconds. So yeah, and by the way, yeah, this combo doesn't lose to Nibiru anyways, since you only make 3 summons. So even if you have Conductor, it's still only summon number 4. And this is very nasty. You only need one card to do this, and yeah, sure, you need to play some bricks in the form of Aeolo and every single Yang Xing card, but it's, you know, back in 2017, that was okay. And I'm going to search that 9 pillars, and then send the Chiwin from my deck to my graveyard, and then set to the 9 pillars, and you're going to see what's going to happen as soon as my opponent is going to play that Dark Hole. If it's Dark Hole, yeah. So I'm going to negate it with 9 pillars, because, I mean, okay, let's just say it wasn't Dark Hole, and it was like, I don't know, a pot of greed multiplied by 10, and the card was like, draw 20 cards. Because Dark Hole maybe is a bad example, you might just not even want to negate this. But yeah, let's just say I get the Dark Hole, you know, Pot of Greed in here, and I really want to negate this, so I will just negate to that Pot of Greed, and then I will go Chainlink 1 Deng Long, and then Chainlink 2 Chiwin, so if they top the Ash for turn, they cannot Ash you whatsoever, and you're going to have a level 1 tuner and a level 3 non-tuner that can quick sing during your opponent's turn, and will make whichever synchro monster you summon undestructible by battle, and that's exactly what we're going to do on the resolution. So now we have an undestructible Herald, well, only by battle, but that's actually really scary, because you can't usually Herald is the kind of card that doesn't really stay on the field for too long. You kind of just attack over it and then use your cards, but when it's undestructible by battle, it's absolutely terrifying, because it has a really nasty kind of macrocosmos-esque effect, and it's really hard for people to deal with that. So we also can use its effect to omni negate at any point during the combo, and they can't just, you know, beat over first. So yeah, we just negate it, and that's it, with only one Overraptor. So not too bad, just a single Deng Long does all of that. Now you can kind of understand why it got banned. And now I'm going to show you another combo where, if this card actually comes back in the current metagame, or in a metagame where even Needle Fiber is actually banned, and even Steam the Cloak is still banned, and you know, every other card is still banned, what can you actually do that is really nasty? Let's get right into it. Okay. Does this hand actually look like it can do some nasty shenanigans? Yes, actually, this card can literally deck out your opponent because there is only almost one way in the entire game of Yu-Gi-Oh! To out whichever monster I'm going to show you. And, I mean, there are technically two or three cards that can do it. I mean, yeah. There is the Kaiju family, so Kaiju, Santa Claus, Volcanic Queen, and there is Herald of the Abyss, if I recall correctly, because it is actually your opponent that has to be sending it, and it is not a card effect, if I recall correctly. I mean, the fact that it sends, because it is also unaffected by your own card effects, the Full Armor Master, so I'm not 100% sure on this, but you cannot get Sphere Moded or Lava Golemed as well, so you're going to be activating your Black Whirlwind. You don't necessarily have to be drawing this specific hand, it's just that this is the easiest way of pulling the combo off, but obviously you can just hard draw the cards or just draw a completely different hand and it's still gonna work. You're gonna search for Orochi the Squall and you're gonna summon it, and now you're gonna Synchro Summon Deng Long in attack position because, you know, you're gonna have a defense position Deng Long in case our combo doesn't even work. And we're going to go Chainlink 1 Deng Long to search and Chainlink 2 Orochi to put it in defense. So it chain blocks Ghost Ogre. And yeah, now our Deng Long is going to be in defense. And we're going to add Yangzing Path from your deck to your hand. This is obviously not needed at all. You can just afford not to play this card. Now we're going to send Bian from our deck to grave again in order to make Deng Long level 3. This is very important in the combo actually. And you're going to bounce back Black Whirlwind to summon Zephyros. Now, what is going to be my next step? Just looks really sketch. I don't really have too much to work with. I can make a level 7 Synchro and summon a Yangzing monster from my deck, but that's it. I can't make Needle Fiber because, once again, this is hypothetically speaking, assuming that Needle Fiber is banned, so what am I gonna do? I'm going to summon a vanilla monster, Raikiri. This card does nothing. Literally just does nothing at all. But it becomes a tuner if it was actually synchro summoned by using a Blackwing monster as a material. So now we have a level 7 Blackwing tuner and the ability to summon a Yangzing monster from our deck with Deng Long. What is it gonna be? It's gonna be Bian number 2. I already told you that whichever synchro monster is summoned with the effect of, with Bian as a material, cannot be destroyed by battle. So we're going to make an unaffected by card effects an undestructible Full Armor Master. Yes, it's literally that nasty. And our Yangzing Path is going to shuffle 3 Yangzing cards from our graveyard to our deck and draw 2 cards. So this is disgusting. We have a monster that cannot be that is 100% unaffected by all kinds of effects, cannot be destroyed by battle, gives wedge counters to your opponent, monsters, when they use their effects on the field. During your end phase, you can destroy every monster on the field that has a wedge counter, and you can also steal a monster on your opponent's field that has a wedge counter completely permanently. This is just too much for literally everyone to handle, and there are barely any decks in the entire game that can handle this at all, actually. So Kaijus, like I said, are the only real outs, but apart from that, if my Full Armor Master is in defense, how are you dealing damage through me? You actually need to deal, like, you know, direct attacks, but then it's kind of bad for you, because let's just say you're actually going for Hayate, it's not gonna work out. I'm just going to steal your Hayate, and then, or I can just destroy it multiple times. You're never going to be able to play the game whatsoever. You can't deal enough damage to me. You're always going to have wedge counters on your cards. By the time you actually try to deal, 3,000-4,000 life points, you were already dead a while back, and this is only a 2-card combo. You have 3 other cards in your hand. Your opponent is going to struggle way more, and he just can't deal with a single card. So, like I said, in a tournament, in a YCS, it is extremely likely and very easy to go 17 rounds straight, or 15, or whatever rounds straight, without getting Kaiju a single time, because Kaijus are not staples in Yu-Gi-Oh! They depend way too much on the deck that, you're playing, and not necessarily always good in the meta, so this is definitely a really scary combo that might actually take a lot of people by surprise if Deng Long actually ever comes back. And like I said, this is just a very basic example. The fact that you can do some nasty things like this with Deng Long, and the fact that you can make 2 interruptions just with one single Deng Long, is actually a pretty good testimony of how this card is that good, and why this card got banned, and why this card should probably not come back even if Needle Fiber gets banned. Now, if Needle Fiber doesn't get banned and they are crazy enough to put Deng Long into the game, I can promise you on my life that we're going to be having a ridiculous tier 0 format, because there are already some really stupid, I believe there were Yang Xing Zephra combos that actually used a Deng Long with Needle Fiber. So yeah, that's pretty much all I had to say for this beautiful review on Deng Long. Actually, that isn't really a review, just a hypothetical discussion. But once again, don't forget to like and subscribe, because it motivates me a lot to keep making videos like these. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Peace.